Tentatively, they may be here next week, depending on how she feels. So with that, looks like we got some Christmas songs this morning and some other things going on. So, if y'all want to stand and stretch your legs, the first song is I Need a Silent Night.
Chaos and the noise, I need a minute. I bring you good news of a great joy that shall be for all people. For unto you is born this day a Savior, who is Christ the Lord, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Prince of Peace.
Lay your healing hands upon the many that need healing, Father, here in our church family, our community, and our own families, Father. Lord, if it's your will, just lay your hands upon them, Father, and let your healing presence be felt. Lord, I ask that you be with those that are struggling with other difficulties, Father. You would lay your hands upon them, Father, and give them the strength and peace and wisdom that they need to make any decisions that are upon their heart. Lord, we just ask all this in your Son's precious name. Amen. Y'all may be seated. This next one, if you want, is O Come Emmanuel. It's hymn number 76. Y'all might sing. The words will be up there, or you can open your hymn. Thank you. next one. Is this the video? Okay. Christmas Guest. One of my favorites.
It happened one day near December's end. Two neighbors called on an old-time friend, and they found a shop so meager and mean, made gay with 1,000 boughs of green. And Conrad was sitting with face ashine when he suddenly stopped as he stitched the twine, and he said, "Old friends, at dawn today, when the cock was a-crowing the night away, the Lord appeared in a dream to me and said, I'm coming your guest to be. So I've been busy with feet of stir, strewing my shop with branches of myrrh. The table is spread and the kittle is shined, and over the rafters the holly is twined. And now I'll wait for my Lord to appear, and listen closely so I will hear his step as he nears my humble place. And I open the door and look on his face." So his friends went home and left Conrad alone, for this was the happiest day he had known. For long since his family had passed away, and Conrad had spent many a sad Christmas day. But he knew with the Lord as his Christmas guest, this Christmas would be the dearest and best. So he listened with only joy in his heart, and with every sound he would rise with a start and look for the Lord to be at his door, like the vision he had a few hours before. So he ran to the window after hearing a sound, but all he could see on the snow-covered ground was a shabby beggar whose shoes were torn and all of his clothes were ragged and worn. But Conrad was touched, and he went to the door, and he said, "Your feet must be frozen and sore. I have some shoes in my shop for you, and a coat that'll keep you warmer, too." So with grateful heart, the man went away. But Conrad noticed the time of day, and he wondered what made the dear Lord so late, and how much longer he'd have to wait. When he heard a knock, he ran to the door, but it was only a stranger once more. A bent old lady with a shawl of black and a bundle of kindling piled on her back. She asked for only a place to rest, but that was reserved for Conrad's great guest. But her voice seemed to plead, "Don't send me away. Let me rest for a while on Christmas Day." So Conrad brewed her a steaming cup and told her to sit at the table and sup. But after she left, he was filled with dismay, for he saw that the hours were slipping away, and the Lord hadn't come as he said he would. And Conrad felt sure he had misunderstood, when out of the stillness, he heard a cry, "Please help me and tell me, where am I?" So again he opened his friendly door and stood disappointed as twice before. It was only a child who had wandered away and was lost from her family on Christmas Day. Again Conrad's heart was heavy and sad, but he knew that he could make the little girl glad, so he called her in and wiped her tears and quieted all the childish fear. Then he led her back to her home once more. But as he entered his own darkened door, he knew that the Lord was not coming today. For the hours of Christmas had passed away. So he went to his room and he knelt down to pray. And he said, "Lord, why did you delay? What kept you from coming to call on me? For I wanted so much your face to see." When soft in the silence a voice he heard, "Lift up your head, for I kept my word. 3 times my shadow crossed your floor, 3 times I came to your lonely door, for I was the beggar with bruised cold feet. I was the woman you gave something to eat, and I was the child on the homeless street. Three times I knocked, three times I came in, and each time I found the warmth of a friend. Of all the gifts, love is the best. I was honored to be your Christmas guest.
Think about this Christmas season. You never know when the Lord might reveal himself. Let's see what we got. Announcements. Let's see. Got several I'm going to start with. Brother Ronnie is elected to go to inactive as a deacon due to some health concerns. Brother Sterling is elected to postpone his ordination, so that will not be next week. It on that, and hopefully Renee and them will be here next Sunday. I know Darlene is working on that. If we get confirmation, we'll post it on the Facebook page. Worship opportunities: Sunday morning, 10 o'clock. We have our Sunday school, 11 o'clock, in-person worship. At 6 o'clock on Sunday nights, I pop on there and share something. Wednesday nights at 6:45, we have our prayer meeting and time of fellowship and scripture reading. Today, after service, we're having lunch, so I would encourage you to hang around. I've been over there, there's some good food over there, so get your belly full before you leave. Next week is the 11th. Hopefully Miss Renee and Tommy will be feeling better, and we'll have our Christmas musical during the morning service. And it could change. Just pay attention to the Facebook, and we'll, Darlene, or keep you updated on that. December the 21st is our 6:30 deacons meeting, 6:45 is our business meeting. Sunday, December the 5th, it's Christmas, and we are having service. We've elected to move it to 10 o'clock start time and not have Sunday school, so Christmas morning service will be from 10 to 11 instead of 11 to 12. So be here at 10, that way we can get you out of here at home so you can be with your family for lunch. And we also have the Lottie Moon Christmas offering that morning.
Okay, Mark, may I say something about that?
Yes, ma'am.
That's the day that we will put our offerings in the manger. But if you can't be here that day, I will be collecting that money all month. So if you can't be here for any reason on Christmas Day and you want to go ahead and make your donation, just give it to me. Just make sure you mark on your check. It's for Lottie Moon. I think we've got some envelopes. We'll have them out next week.
Okay.
But, you know, we'll be taking that, will be all month long, but we'll make our offering on Christmas Day like we normally do, but place it in the manger.
In case y'all didn't hear, Miss Mary Ann will be taking the Lottie Moon offering all month. If you write a check, just notate in there that it's for Lottie Moon, and they'll have some envelopes out for that. And then Christmas morning, you can put your offering in a little.
The manger.
Birthdays. Hannah has her 19th birthday today. Woo, makes me feel old. Goodness gracious. Morgan Green on the 9th, Grady on the 11th, and Kelsey on the 18th. Don't have very many December birthdays. Got any anniversaries? Oh, Mr. Ronnie and Miss Alina have an anniversary on the
Friday.
Well, I hope y'all celebrate and have a good time. Go dancing, cutting the rug, you know, something. And then Mr. Miller and Miss Peggy have one on the 7th. I know y'all will have a good time. And I think that is it. Where's Miss Kathy? Miss Kathy? Oh.
The list for the poinsettias is in the vestibule, and I'll make sure we have another one put out whenever we have the Christmas party. But I did make a list, and I want you to look at it. If I need to make any changes, please let me know. But there's a list in the on the bench.
And do we have any left?
No. I mean, we can probably get some more.
Well, I didn't know if we had any.
No.
Okay.
All of them. In fact, I probably need to get a couple more.
I think that's
more. Yeah.
And thank you, Ms. June, for getting these beautiful poinsettias. I don't know, it's just something. With poinsettias in a church, it just makes the church pop. So, and Miss Kathy's going to have a little something for the kids. All right.
They celebrate birthdays, anniversaries, and an
apple.
It won't go out. Well.
He go to work with you too?
Move out of your way, okay.
No,
I'm never done. Well, what a pleasure. Yes, amen. So glad to have you here.
Need a light. Maybe I'll start somebody.
You made the same call. What you gonna get?
What you get inside, dog?
The president.
That's right. You don't care what you get, long as they feed you, do. Right. A newborn. That's pretty appropriate here. 2 Peter 3:9. God is being patient with you. He does not want anyone to be lost. He wants everyone to change his heart and life. To those who believe that Jesus is our Savior, He has promised a new birth into a new life with God. It's a life free of the shame of past mistakes and a life full of hope in heaven. Thank you. Does that mean that your old, sinful side will never show its ugly head again? Or that you'll never be tempted to do wrong again? To answer that question, compare your new birth in Jesus to a newborn baby. Can a baby walk or feed himself or sing or read or speak? No, but somebody else will. You going to take care of that baby?
Nope.
No, sir. Before long, you'll have him on the four-wheeler, though, right? It takes time for a baby to grow and learn. But in the hospital delivery room, is the parent ashamed of the baby? Is the mom embarrassed that the baby can't spell or walk or stand up or give a speech? Of course not. The parents aren't ashamed. They are proud. They know the baby will grow and learn in time. God knows that you will grow and learn too. Look back through your baby pictures. See how much you've changed, grown, and learned. Your parents didn't toss you out of the house when you stumbled as a toddler. God won't either. He'll lift you up, dust you off, and help you take the next step. Amen. Isn't that a wonderful thing to know?
Amen.
Anybody want to pray for us, or y'all want me to pray? Want me to pray? All right. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this wonderful family that's here with us today, Lord. They're such a blessing to each and every one of us, and we love them, and we know they love us. And Lord, we thank you for this church and this little church, and even though the attendance is not great, Lord, but we're one or more is gathered together, Lord. We know you're in the midst. Thank you for all your blessings and this special time of Christmas, and may we never, never forget the reason for the season. Thank you, Jesus, for keeping us safe. Be with the ones that's sick or just lost loved ones at this time, Lord. Just wrap your arms around them and let them know they're not going through this alone. Thank you for all your blessings. We love you, Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
What is that? Playground. Playground.
You know, talking about baby pictures. Hey, some of mine scare me, so haven't seen some of mine, so yeah. I'm just glad I grew out of them baby pictures. And some of my hairstyles and clothing attire was, oof, it was awful back in the day. But it's kind of like our relationship with the Lord. You know, we start as a child, and we, as we grow, just like a child, our relationship with the Lord should grow as well into those teen years and into the adulthood. adult stage, our relationship should be firm with the Lord. And that's why it's so important for us to strive to have that relationship. So